Hi everyone, it's Shane from Hanlon's for another Maintenance Monday. Today we're going to go over the Autosteer settings in the Datatronic 5 for the WR9980 windrower. That's all new for 2022, so we'll step into the cab. So in this episode, we're going to go over the Datatronic 5 Autosteer screen in the windrower. If you look, it's very similar layout. You can see your GPS signal up in the top, your date and your time. There are no other screens that you scroll back and forth to. It shows you which field you're on. You have the hamburger menu that gives you windrower functions or system setup. System setup is going to go in there. It's going to tell you the type of correction you have, the type of antenna. This isn't really something that you're going to use. It goes through and shows a bunch of functions for the techs when they come out to your machine. So going to the basic screen, it's laid out very, very similar. If you're gonna make a line, so normally you would see the plus here, we touch it, and then you would add a field. You take that and put whatever name you want in there. So we'll call it new field 5. You can see that changed up here now. And then what you would do is this button makes your boundary. This one adds your line. You touch those plus buttons. It makes an extended menu out and asks you what kind of line you want to use. So you put your A point and your B point or your heading, whatever you're using. Moving down, you've got flags. So if you want to flag a rock or something like that, you have that ability as well. The bottom one is your nudge buttons and your nudge functions. You can touch that and it expands it out. Most of the time you're going to have that preset already and you're just going to use the nudge buttons on your joystick. If you have that cut in set, then you will get a proper acres per hour. The other button is that gear down at the corner. It allows you to go in and change different things as far as your menus. The main thing that you're going to use is the steering wheel to adjust your online sensitivity or your line acquire aggressiveness. They call it wayline catch-up in here. The other one is your overlap. So you're going to have that set between 14 and 18 inches on WAS, depending on what you're doing. And then the other setting here that you will use is the header cut in, and really that's going to be done once, so that when the header drops below that mark, it starts to count acres for you. As before, return always gets you back. You get back to that main screen and away you go. Hopefully that helps you out. Thanks for watching.